When Jen and I first moved to town, we looked around a lot of different places for where we could actually start having church experiences, Sunday morning worship gatherings. And I talked to the local high schools, I talked to the local movie theaters, I talked to a whole bunch of places, and this was the only place that opened up to us. At the time, there was a whole lot of red tape that you had to jump through with regard to the school board and the superintendent of schools, janitors and things like that. But this was the place that opened up for us. God opened up one door, and it was here. And when we got launched here, it was amazing. In our first couple of Sundays, we had well over 100 people showing up, perhaps 200 during our first couple of weeks showing up. And I was amazed at how effective our ministry could be here. But after being a church doing public Sunday morning worship gatherings for only 6 weeks, in early summer of 2007, we had to leave the place God had opened to us to be at Tecumseh Junior High. I remember feeling really disappointed, really frustrated, wondering why it was that God had opened the door for us down at Wee Our Ridge Elementary School, the exact place where we had wanted to be. And then he closed that door again. That school had some stuff they wanted to do during the summer. They wanted to keep their building closed during the summer. And that was fine. They have the right to do that. But I was like, God, why would you lead us to that place and then close that door? This was the only door that opened up to us, and so we moved here. Our first Sunday up here, we had 40 people. After the week before having nearly 200, somewhere maybe around 150, we didn't even have enough volunteers to count the people, so I don't know what the number was, but we had like 150 down there at Wee Our Ridge Elementary, and then we moved up here and we were down to 40. Although, that first Sunday we were in Tecumseh Junior High, I do remember we had a baptism that afternoon and baptized 3 people. That was pretty cool. But still, I was asking God the question, why would you move us from the place we thought was going to be our home to somewhere completely different? And then, at the end of the summer of 2007, we had to leave this place too. To the Holiday Inn. Ah, for 3 different locations in our first 6 months. At the end of the summer, Tecumseh Junior High said we couldn't be there anymore, and so we had to relocate again, and we couldn't go back down to Wee Our Ridge for a number of reasons, and they wouldn't let us stay at Tecumseh Junior High for a number of reasons, and so the Holiday Inn was the only place that opened up to us. And once again, I remember thinking, God, why did you lead us to another location? I mean, our church name was the Southside Church at the time, and yet we weren't anywhere near the south side of town anymore. Our whole mission, our whole vibe of everything just seemed to be changing. And I was like, God, what are you doing? But while we were here, we grew. We had like 80 people started coming. We were in the ballroom on the second floor. We had the kids in some of the conference rooms on the first floor. And we even had 2 different baptisms in their swimming pool here. Good things happened. But still, I kind of was disappointed. The plan wasn't working out the way I thought the plan should work out. God had led us somewhere else. And then he led us somewhere else again, to the Long Center. And oh my goodness, our first Sunday here, I was so disappointed. I was so worried. Oh, you see, we had been a church for 1 year since our grand opening. It was the last Sunday in March. It was our 1 year anniversary, and it was Easter Sunday, and I was all excited about having a 1 year anniversary, Easter Sunday, all that kind of thing at our home over there at the Holiday Inn. But then they gave me a phone call and they said, oh no, it's March Madness and the NCAA women's basketball teams are all staying here at the Holiday Inn. And so you can't meet here on that particular Sunday. I said, don't you know it's Easter? They said, yeah. I said, don't you know it's our 1 year anniversary? They said, okay. And no, we couldn't. And the Long Center was the only place that opened up their doors to us. And so we took our 80 people and we came over here to the Long Center into a room that could hold 1,200. Oh man. And I just remember being so disappointed. But you know what? It was in the Long Center where we ended up meeting some of the most long-term faithful members of our church. It was in the Long Center where we ended up on one Sunday baptizing 14 people. Yeah, a lot of cool things happened at the Long Center. We ended up staying there for quite some time. Well, that is until we had to move again. And so we moved here to the building that we call Braddock. It's a building, our address was on Braddock Road, which is right out here. We just didn't have enough children's space in the Long Center and decided, okay, let's finally bite the bullet and get ourselves the first permanent location that would really be for us. And this opened up. We shopped around for a bunch of different places, and it was almost like God just dropped this place into our lap. One of the stories that I tell people a lot is that when Jen and I first moved to town, there was a church that had just left this building. And we didn't know if the church had gone out of business or what, but I remember I brought our launch team. Before we ever had any public services, I brought our launch team, and we stood in front of this building right here, and we prayed, and we said, God, if there's something you could do to redeem what happened here in this place, we'd love for you to do it. And lo and behold, years later, God led us to this very place, gave us a really good deal from the landlord, and it ended up being the first permanent location we ever had as a church. It was amazing how God kind of led our hearts here at one point in time, and then years later, led the church back here. And that put us back on the south end of town anyway, and it was fun. We spent like 5 years here, and the Kidopolis program went well. We went to 2 worship gatherings, had a pretty good time, but you know, eventually we had to move again. And so we ended up here. The Braddock building just didn't have enough space for our kids, and we had the opportunity to purchase a building right next door to a strip club, so hey, why not? And this place has been good to us. I remember when we moved here, I was having those mixed feelings. You know, it was like, God, why are we moving to this location? Why are we having the issues that we're having with the remodeling and some of those things? But overall, it was a pretty exciting thing. It's one of the only moves that we made that I think most of the people involved had some enthusiasm for, except for the fact that a few people decided they didn't want to join us over here. And so we lost a fairly significant number of people in the church. And once again, it was one of those experiences where God was leading us, and yet there was also disappointment mixed into it. And that's why I decided to show you all these locations today for our video, because the next part of the Lord's Prayer says, "And lead us not into temptation." Now, one of the fascinating things about that is that the Bible clearly tells us that temptation is exactly the one thing God will never lead us into. And so for Jesus to tell us to pray, "Heavenly Father, lead us not into temptation," it really raises the question. I mean, that's the one thing God will never lead us into. So what's the point of praying it? Well, I think Jesus is doing something sneaky there. You know, he's doing one of these things where he's asking us to pray something that is definitely going to be answered with a yes, because he wants us to think about what it means. You see, if I'm honest with myself, I'm the one who leads me into temptation. And so if I'm leading me, then temptation is still on the table. Doing the wrong thing, sinning, is still on the table. But if God is leading me, temptation's not on the table. If God is leading me, then doing the wrong thing is no longer on the table. You see, if I pray, "Lead me not into temptation," I'm saying, "God, lead me." I mean, that's the real point of the prayer. The one thing God will never do is lead me into temptation. And so that prayer, when I say, "God, lead me not into temptation," I'm effectively saying, "God, don't lead me anywhere you would not want me to go, but go ahead and lead me anywhere else." That line of the prayer says, "God, wherever you lead, that's where I'll go." As a church, we've been led to a number of different locations. And in every one of those moves, there were questions. In every one of those moves, there were disappointments. But also in every one of those moves, we got to see God move in a new way, in a different way. And so whether you're facing some uncertainty now, or as a church, whether we're facing some uncertainty, the point isn't God make me comfortable, the point is God lead me. And so join me together in praying that. God, lead us as individuals and lead us as a church. We know you'll never lead us into temptation or sin. So go ahead and lead us anywhere else.